Underdogs of Addiction fam. Today's video, I want to talk about depression and addiction. The two go hand in hand. I believe a lot of people, if not all of us who struggle with substance abuse, struggle with depression. It's been a battle I've faced ever since I was a little kid. I could remember being 4 or 5 years old and just feeling this overwhelming emotions and just like crying for no reason. I remember the memory. And I remember my mom and her friend coming in and they're like, "What's wrong?" And I said, "I don't know. I just like felt overwhelmingly sad." And off and on throughout my life, I've struggled with it. Obviously, it's very much in my adult life. My teenage years, not so much. My young adult years, not so much. But my you know, past 25 to now 35, definitely. It's something I struggle with every single day, just to varying degrees. Some days it's, you know, only a few levels of it, but I'm going to show you guys kind of where I'm at. I'm over here at this beautiful park here. But some days, you know, like today, I wake up and I feel it. And I just want to talk about it because, you know, in life, it's normal to feel depression. Some of us, you know, you go through a death in a family, a job loss, a relationship loss, a physical, a mental injury. It's normal to feel depressed. If your life is not in order, like Jordan Peterson says, it's normal to feel depressed. You know, and I'm in a situation kind of where my life is partly in order and partly not. You know, I struggled a lot in close emotional relationships due to my attachment issues. And at 35, I've been in a place where I'm just sad, you know, that I don't have a family as far as like a wife. And all my relationships the last 3 years, I've been with 3 different girls in the last 3-4 years, you know, usually for about a year or a little more, but my relationships don't last much longer than that, and they usually end up bad, like roller coasters. And of course I've took my part in it, and so I've been doing therapy the last few years and working on that stuff. And it's just, it's hard sometimes, and it's very sad when you want to have a family. And ladies, maybe you're a woman and you're struggling with finding a good guy and you want to have a family. And I've just been struggling with that. And I know a lot of you guys out here watching this can relate, because I get a lot of comments. I just got a comment to today about a guy talking about his loneliness after his divorce and him struggling with finding a good partner. And, you know, what I wanted to kind of bring up in this is, what are my thoughts on using medication? For years I was like always against it. I started flirting with the idea of medication, you know, when I started going to therapy. I would get prescriptions and never use them. And I've done all this trauma work, I've done a lot of good things, exercise, eating well, doing all these things, and I would still get these dark depressions every now and then. And I noticed that my rate of relapse would be very high when I feel that depression, because I didn't know how to get out of that feeling. And what do people do who struggle with substance abuse when they're depressed or when they're stressed? They use, because sometimes the stress or the depression is debilitating. And so I had to learn to have compassion for myself when I used, but I also had to take responsibility to working on that. And so where I'm getting at today, guys, is now I am trying medication. I've been on it for almost 3 weeks. I think it's called Flazodone. I've been using that one because it has way less side effects than most of the other ones. I've tried a couple other ones. Some of them made me feel kind of numb. One of them made me kind of way too hyper. This one, I've been finding some really good balance, and I still feel like myself, and the side effects are very minimal. And I just got to a point, guys, where I realized like I needed something, because my depression was just, the lows were just getting too low. You know, suicidal thoughts, no plan of action or anything, but not wanting to hurt myself, but feeling so just depressed that I'm just like, man, I want to go to heaven already. I want to go be in peace. But then other days, you know, I have great times, you know, so those depressive states usually pass. And most of the time I'm pretty happy person. But I had to really take responsibility for the depression. So I'm back in therapy and I'm on medication. And you know, it takes weeks to months for it to really kick in. But just cause you're on medication and in therapy, guys, that does not immune you from, having depression. I'm still going through stuff right now. You know, a recent breakup that I've been dealing with, you know, off and on for the last year, dealing with what I just talked about with the relationship stuff. You know, this economy, for some of us, money is a little tight. For all of us, I mean, unless you're rich. And so just dealing with that, issues at work in my career as a peer counselor, dealing with being triggered by my new job that I got, working at Ground Zero, basically with the most hardcore addicts in my city, and having to take a step back and realize that I'm not well enough to do that job. So now doing an apprenticeship for my buddy's drywall company. And so that's what I'm doing now. And that's been helping. I was not well enough to do a job helping these people. And part of that depression was seeing these people at these low levels of living and illness mentally and addiction wise and not being able to really help them, and seeing my own father in them. And my own father's dying from his addiction right now, poly addict, mainly fentanyl, meth, alcohol. And so that's where I'm at, guys. And I guess I just want to make this video to let you know, like, if you're struggling with some depression right now, yo, that, like, you're not alone. And I know how it feels. I know how it feels to want to just cry and to scream and to just be like, dude, like, I love life, but I don't want to feel this way anymore. Just like the Joker said in the movie, he was like, I just don't want to be so sad anymore. Or he said something like that. They were like, Arthur, you're on 7 medications. He's like, I just don't want to feel so bad anymore, you know? But the thing with me is, a lot of times I just feel better. And when I come out here in nature, meditate, you know, and I mean, that boosted me up 25%, you know? So just finding gratitude in the small things, you know, and if you're out there struggling with depression and you've never got any help, you know, I know how hard it is to reach out and to say that you need help, but I'm telling you, it's worth it. Medication wise, you know, it's sometimes hard to find the right meds, but you just got to keep trying them and, you know, and seeing what works for you. I'm telling you, I was the most anti-medication guy, and I would quit stuff after I felt this and that. And I finally found stuff that's worked for me. There's actually like DNA tests you can do to show you like which meds you will spawn better to. So I just kind of want to put this out there to let you know you guys aren't alone, and that I'm out here too. And a lot of my friends in recovery as well have to take medication, and that's on top of doing everything else, like exercising, eating healthy, socializing, staying connected. So many of us are depressed because we're just not connected. We're isolated. We don't belong to any social groups. We have low social ties. So make sure you're checking off those boxes, you guys. And a lot of us addicts want to isolate, and that's just gonna, you know, magnify your depression. And so whenever I feel like isolating, I push myself to get out and go out, however I got to do it. And you know, the majority of people who struggle with addiction, it all stems from trying to cover up and bury those painful feelings. And you know, you're not alone, but it is your responsibility to try to deal with those feelings. And for some of us, the best way we know how is to use at the time. And you shouldn't beat yourself up about it, but also be honest and say, hey, I'm using this because I don't know how to cope with the pain I'm dealing with. And sometimes, in a weird way, those addictions keep you alive, but it's a kind of like a slow burn until they kill you. So, you know, obviously that's not the answer. And sometimes we need help, and sometimes it's medical help, sometimes it's holistic help, whatever it is, you know. But we're not alone. You guys aren't alone. I would like you guys to just, you know, comment and kind of share your stories of what depression looks like for you. For me, I could just say in my lowest depression spells, it kind of feels like I can't see the sun. It's just dull, the cloud. Like I look at stuff and I just can't feel anything from it. When I'm depressed, it's like you get no, it's like apathy. It's like you don't feel, the things that make you happy don't make you feel that way. The things you're passionate about don't make you feel passionate anymore. And it just feels like the world is about to end, or the world is ending. That's how it feels, you know, for me. You know, I know people have severe levels where they literally can't get out of bed. I've never been really like that. So I feel for those folks. But for me, it's like it got to a point where I was like, okay, I need to get medicated because I just can't. I have a biological component, but I'm also got a lot of life things going on, and a lot of people have a lot of life things going on. So like Jordan Peterson said, don't underestimate the impact that, you know, the medications out there can help, because everyone wants to be like, oh, I'm anti-medication, anti this, but you know, if I broke my leg in half and I'm in severe pain, I'm gonna want them to put something in, give me some opiate or something to help deal with that while I'm in surgery. You know, there is obviously risk factors, but I'm just saying, there's a lot of great medications and there is a need. And so you hear it all the time, you know, you got fucking diabetes, you need your insulin, right? So you've got a biological component in your brain. You got to think, when we're using, most of us and everyone I know that uses, we're trying to fulfill, you know, not only bury something, but a lot of us, our brain circuitries, our serotonin circuits, our dopamine, norepinephrine circuits, serotonin, all that, were short-circuited in childhood. There's literally proof that shows that the circuits literally are not the same. And so we're always trying to feed that. And so you got to find natural ways and sometimes healthier pharmacological ways to deal with that. And so that's all I wanted to talk about, you guys, today. Nothing's wrong with getting medicated. Nothing's wrong with getting professional help. And, you know, like Jordan Peterson says, you know, like, well, if you're on the verge of killing yourself, you might as well try some fucking medication. You'll know in 30 days if it works, you know? So, and if you're on the risk of overdosing or relapsing because of your depression, you're better off trying some antidepressants. Now, you know, people, extremists will go, oh, you know, you can develop tolerance and then you have withdrawals. Yeah, you will, but you get withdrawals from caffeine. You get withdrawals from marijuana. Like, you know, there's ways to go about things, is all I'm saying. So you got to pick your, choose your side. Anyways, guys, I'm going to send you guys off to this nice, beautiful view here. Have a great day.